Welcome to episode 2, the series of Building X8. We really need a new title. Please comment below some ideas. But this is the series where I show you guys what it's like running my media company. Last week, I talked about all the projects I'm working on in my company and my new pivot. But this week, I was contemplating if it's still a good idea to pivot. Here's some context. I used to have a dream job, okay? I used to dream of working and hustling every single day, bowing down to capitalism and just grinding my eyes out. I wanted to be the female version of Gary Vaynerchuk. So I kind of did that. I just started my own media company, X8, and I just started grinding. Never stopped. It's been 3 years of doing that. That's when I realized I have a problem. I can't do anything without obsessively criticizing myself and high expectations. No, I get it. That sounds pretty conceited. Like, Jade, what the fuck? Why are you complaining? Like, just sit down. Like, your life is good. I want to add a disclaimer that I'm extremely grateful that my passion is my job. I just wanted to make this video because I know a lot of people are entering the creator economy, whether it's making your own YouTube channel or monetizing a small business. I just wanted to show the dark truth that I don't think people talk about entering the creator economy, which is, what do you do when your passion doesn't feel like a passion anymore? AKA, you hate your work. I think this is such a huge reality. For example, I picked up surfing about a year ago. I used it as a means to escape. It was helping my anxiety until I started to document it on TikTok. I got millions of views for my surfing videos. Now I obsessively think about the analytics and views and how I can make money. And it's extremely hard for me to go out surfing without literally feeling like it's a chore. It's a job that I feel pressured and I have to expect it to make money in some sort of way. Another example is I make videos on the internet and I've been making videos for 10 years. I used to make content because I wanted to express myself playing with dolls. You know, you guys know I had a YouTube channel where I played with dolls and it was just fun. Like, I was a kid just expressing myself on the internet, making a bunch of internet besties. But then I wanted to make money out of social media. It was my choice. So I do acknowledge that, but it just started to feel like instead of an outlet for me to express myself, it was a way for me to turn on the lights. I had to worry about views, CPM, and now I literally can't make a video without feeling immense anxiety on how it will perform and affect my career. I used to hold meetups with you guys and just hang out with y'all because I like meeting you guys. Dharma Nation is amazing. But now I can't even find myself to do a meetup virtually without it having direct ROI. Like, it has to make money, it has to make sense. I can't do something just for fun. It's like this thing where I'm making money out of what I do for fun, so I feel guilty that I'm kind of living this, so I have to like overwork myself to compensate the fact that like I am working hard enough. Does that make any sense? I'm just gonna be honest, I'm getting into some pretty unhealthy habits that maybe I can explain in a future video, but it's linked to some disordered eating, and I want to figure out a way to enjoy my work. I want to be able to have hobbies again, to have an outlet where I can work and then have something that relieves my anxiety. Or else I'm going insane. I'm going insane. So I started researching. I listened to a podcast by Gary Vaynerchuk, who I really still do like, and he was talking about what to do when your hobby that you monetize feels like a job and a chore. And he said to demonetize it. What? Basically, he was saying if your passion becomes your job and you don't like your job anymore because it doesn't feel like a passion, you should demonetize it and you should just take off the pressure and expectation for it to pay your bills. Which honestly makes sense to me. Actually, before this video, I made a whole other video explaining my plans to make myself love working and making videos again, which is going from X8 to my new pivot to create. And in that video, I basically explained that this is gonna make me happier because maybe I'm not happy making money this way, so I'll make money this way. This will make me happier. But that would only last for another 2.2 seconds before I realize it becomes a chore. The passion becomes a job. The interest becomes something that has an expectation. So what's the solution? Is it demonetizing it like Gary Vaynerchuk says? Well, I think it's a little bit of both. I think the truth of it is you have to remove expectation. And if that's removing money out of it, that might be the choice. For me, I think I'm putting unnecessary pressure for something to succeed immediately. I want the things I do to make a lot of money and also make me extremely happy. And I do think it exists. I think you can do what you love and it can make money, but it lasts for 2.2 seconds until you set another goal and this becomes a chore and it's just not long-term thinking. Damn, does this sound depressing? I told you guys, this video is a little sad, but trust me, it's gonna get a little bit better. If the solution to making myself enjoy surfing and making videos again is removing expectation, I have to stop judging myself if I have a video that has less views. Like, I need to be a little kinder to Jade and stop being a little bitch when things don't go my way. So I'm gonna show you guys my plan to remove expectation and give myself a little bit of compassion while I start to enjoy what I do better. If you're feeling like nothing you're doing is working and you're just trying to build a company or a YouTube channel and it's just not getting views, I hope this video can help you see that I struggle with it too and we're in this together, B. The first expectation I have to remove is the revenue needing to be predictable. You know, running an agency, this is a seasonal business. Advertising is seasonal. People don't buy things year round the same, right? Christmas is a hot season, that's Q4, where people spend money on gifts, and that's maybe when my company will thrive. So some months like this will be drier, and that's just the nature of advertising. Just a recap from last week, X8 Media had some client projects that are doing really, really well. Currently, we have 3 clients. We call them Whale 1, Whale 2, and Whale 3. I have to keep all these projects anonymous, so I use these terms because I'm under NDA. But Whale 1 went live last week. I actually can announce it. It was P&G or Procter & Gamble. We did a campaign with King Science, and it just went live, which is super fun. Whale 2 is still in the works. It's a huge company that I'm really excited to announce, but that'll be launching in the next 2 weeks. And Whale 3 is a freelancing platform. I just secured a 5-figure budget and more to come from that soon. We also got a project extended from a company called Extra, which is a debit card company. They rehired us to run another month of their creator partnerships. So that's cool. Last week, I also had 2 meetings with some potential leads. Leads are essentially projects that I haven't closed yet, but I'm in the process of nurturing. There's one company, let's call them Whale 4. They are a huge apparel brand and they want to do some Generation Alpha strategy with me. I'll do some consulting. Whale 5 is this tech platform that's, again, a whale in a sense of, I think they want to hire me for some consulting, but that project is still in the works. So as you can see, there's a bunch of projects going on at X8. We're grinding away, but deep down, I'm going to be honest, I'm scared shit. My deepest fear is like, I run this company, X8, we grinding away, we hire a bunch of people, and all of a sudden projects dry up like a fucking prune, and I owe a bunch of people money, and I'm worried that I'm not gonna be able to provide because I didn't project well enough and I didn't plan ahead into the future. So I'm living in this constant worrying battle of like, will I survive next quarter? Ugh. But I had to realize that I think everybody deals with that in some sort of way. Whether it's you don't know what job you're gonna get after college, or you don't know what career you wanna go after because you're not happy. Like, I think that the unknown is totally normal. I need to give myself compassion when things are up and down and projects are not necessarily consistent, that running an agency, being a founder of a media company is a part of the process. Like, not everything is gonna be project after project. It's gonna be sometimes a dry spout. There's gonna be some dry moments and really abundant moments, but that's what it's like running a company in advertising. And of course there's ways to make more passive income, but in terms of the nature of my company and its current state, like, I have to be able to not just accept it for what it is, but I have to be comfortable with being uncomfortable. So if you're trying to figure out something in your life, like, trust me, it's really tough, and it's okay to not have everything figured out. Expectation 2 is your team won't make mistakes. Agency work is tough. I mentioned in the last video that I currently work on negotiating contracts, pitching creators, and working with the legal team, and that work is not necessarily the most fun. So I'm working on outsourcing this a little bit better. I'm planning to still take on negotiating because I feel like that's a part of my strength, but definitely trying to outsource the invoicing, the contracting to my assistant. And I am struggling to do so because I have this fear of like, if I don't do it, it's not going to be done well. And I realize like, that's just not true. Like, your team might make mistakes, and that has nothing to do with you making a bad decision. If anything, that's a part of growing. You have to trust people to grow, Jade. Here it is. I'm trying to remove the judgment that everything has to be perfect when scaling. Scaling is a tough period, and I am doing everything I can to create standard operating procedures, to train my team on certain protocols, but I have to be okay with the little mishaps, little oopsies, you know? And that's a part of learning. That's a part of growing. So I'm trying to remove the expectation of like, everything has to be perfect so I can scale and I can actually outsource the things that I need to. I think the last expectation I have is your views and money define you. Like, I think the biggest thing is I expect the views and revenue in my company to define me. I expect it to make me feel more confident. And honestly, this is the biggest reason why doing a job that's your passion is dangerous. Like, when what you do for fun personally is mixed with what you do to turn on the lights professionally, the line is blurred and you start to take things very personally. If something bad happens at work, you're like, I am a bad person. And this is something, I know this sounds really dramatic, but this actually happened to me last week. So 3 days ago, I was kicked out of my entrepreneurship group. I've been with this group for about 2 years. It's a group of over 50 young, extraordinary founders and athletes and creators. I was kicked out. Let's just name the founder of this group called Mark. And it was a very exclusive group. It is elite. It's basically a cult. Okay, I can say that now. But he told me, Mark told me that I'm no longer accepted into the group because I'm not achieving enough. I was one of the first people in this group, and to just be removed out of not only a networking group, but a friend group, just fucking booted out like that. Like, I was so furious. You know, you guys know me. I used to do boxing. If we were in person, if Mark saw me in real life, I'd be about to poof. But graciously, I don't do that. I don't believe in violence. But I was super upset, so I just said, peace out. Bye. I had to remind myself in that moment that just because someone doesn't think you are accepted and valuable into a society does not mean you are a bad person. You know, you might be kicked out of a friend group at school, and that's the same level of pain I'm feeling, you know, like that, like feeling like you're not good enough for your friends sucks. It sucks. I was struggling to really not judge myself. And the truth is, you are not your bank statements. You are not what you do. What you do at work is not who you are. And especially the way people perceive you is not who you are. Damn, when did Jade become a TED Talk? Make sure you like this video if you're so far enjoying this. By the way, I might make a whole video exposing this elitist cult leader. So if you guys want that, let me know, because I have more stories where that came from. So I have this new strategy. What if I redefine my definition of success from attaining a dream job to getting a job or career that allows me to do the following? Having enough time to create freely and working with creative people. For me, these two things, for me personally, are how I define success. It's about having enough time to make art. You know, I used to be a musician and artist, as you can see in the wall. Having friends that I can work with as creative people that I respect. They don't have to be famous people. They just have to be decent humans that are creative and inspire me. To me, that's success. It's not about having a dream job. It's about having something that allows you to have enough time. And if the time can allow you to work with creative people, for me, that would make me really happy. In terms of getting more time, I plan to do the following with X8. X8 is my media company. We're an influencer agency. And the goal is for me to generate more revenue in X8 so I can have more time. And this revenue I can use to hire people and keep growing, like I mentioned in the beginning, so I can have more time. Like, the key is for me to have enough time to make art and just spend time being myself and not worry about project to project. So there's two things I have with this. I'm gonna plan to actually charge more money with my projects. I used to take client projects that were like lower than $5,000, but now I think I'm gonna set a project minimum of $25,000, and anything below I have to outsource to someone else just because it will not be worth my time. I used to do consulting for $500 an hour, and I'm gonna increase that to $750. I used to not charge any money if I spoke at events, but I'm gonna start to put a project minimum at $5,000. And lastly, this is kind of weird, but I decided not to take any sponsorships for my channels for a while if I wouldn't promote them for free. And I know this is kind of weird and a little bit ironic, but I find that, like, I want to be selective and mindful of the projects I take. I want to work with creative people. And if it's not a brand that I love and genuinely fuck with, like, why would I recommend it to you guys? So I'm just charting. If you guys notice that I won't take as many sponsors, or at least they have to be something that I promote for free. For me, it's my way of trying to be very intentional with my time and not just take on more money just to be more busy, but just being very intentional with it. The second thing I'm thinking about is figuring out a way to outsource more items. So planning to hire in the next few months and just keep growing the team. I currently have an assistant, a copywriter, two editors, and a legal team and a finance team. But I think that I could definitely use more room to grow it and pay my team as well. So by charging more money, I'm able to funnel this into growing the back end. Or at least that's the idea. I'm able to see my company more objectively when I stop trying to find meaning in my work or try to define myself in the numbers. Like, no, I'm just trying to get more projects, charge more money, outsource, grow the team so everyone can be taken care of. And that's that. I don't need to add almost my ego in itself to, like, find my self-worth and everything. I see it more objectively in a sense of, like, let's grow, let's scale, let's take it to the moon. But that doesn't define me. The second thing I want to touch on is my second goal of working with more creative people. And I think this is a little different because, to me, this is what I think I want Create to be. For those who don't know, Create is a creative incubator where we help creators launch long-term businesses. I mentioned in my last video, I'm pivoting into crypto. And by the way, if you guys haven't seen my last video, you should definitely check it out. I'll link it below. So definitely bounce around after you watch this video. But I'm experimenting to turn Create into a social token incubator where we help creators launch their own currency. And that's a way for them to monetize and launch a business through their community. Before, the way I positioned Create was a way for me to make more money and to scale things bigger. And I realized like that's not gonna solve anything. Trying to make money out of Create instead of X8 is not gonna solve my problem of feeling like I'm not enjoying anything. Because although I'm interested into crypto and I'm interested into creator products, like, once I fully monetize that, I put a lot of expectation on it immediately, I find that I'm going to not enjoy it as much. So I'm redefining the goal for Create. Instead of it making money immediately in the first year, I'm just trying to build a creative incubator where I get to work with creative people and work on projects with people. Like that's it. And if I make money from it, cool, but if I don't, I'm not going to expect it. So I'm kind of experimenting with this idea of like X8 is like my day job. Let it become my the cash cow. And Create is my passion project. It's something that I don't want to expect immediately. And by separating the two, I'm able to look at it more objectively. One makes money, one is something that fuels my purpose. And I think before when I clouded everything together, everything just started to have too much expectation and I wasn't able to look at it objectively. I think it's just so important that your dream job doesn't have to be something where you love what you do every single minute. I don't think you have to monetize everything that you like. And that if you monetize your dream or your passion, it's gonna make you happier. I think that's a very unrealistic expectation and it's not true.
Shout out to the content winner. Comment on this post to be featured in the next episode.